Yeah, it's a long, painful process, learning to paint. It's not a quick thing. I've ruined a lot of canvases over the years. The landscape in Colorado and Utah offers pretty much unlimited variety of subject matter, but typically I'll choose a location like a particular valley, and I will go there and see what kind of things catch my eye. Landscape painting is a little more of a challenge, obviously, because being out in nature, the lighting changes from minute to minute. Bugs get stuck in the painting. The wind can blow things around, and rain can start. I've painted in the snow, which I prefer not to do. Whether it's 2 miles or 200 miles, I like to see how much space I can try and encapsulate in a painting, even on a small scale. I think a tiny painting can have an incredible sense of space. Atmospheric perspective is something that I employ and really enjoy working with, the way colors change from up close to a distance. Different colors fall off quicker in that distance than others. So as the landscape becomes farther and farther away, you start to get more of the cool colors, which reads as something with depth and space and air in it. Very seldom do I include buildings or people or anything like that in my work. I tend to really respond to natural and untouched areas. Part of that is the fact that those areas are becoming more and more rare, and I think that type of scenery is something that's going to mean more to people as time goes on. Typically, I like to paint outdoors with the sun to the back of my painting, so I'm looking at it in shade. I'm painting it in the shade. I turn it around in the sunlight and it's a completely different painting. It lights up like a Roman candle. Part of the fun is the happy accident. When something is lit differently, you will see different elements in the painting that you obviously put there, but maybe they weren't obvious to you as you were doing them. Once I've found what I want to paint, distill it down to a few large masses. And once all of those come together on the canvas, at that moment the light comes into the work and it seems to have its own light source. But at that moment it becomes, I think, a painting. It becomes something with a life of its own and an energy and a dynamic that is unique. And there really is a moment where it becomes real.